More than anything, Vivo's NEX S is a fascinating machine. From a distance, it seems like any other big-screen smartphone. Look more closely, though, and the ambition becomes strikingly clear. An in-display fingerprint sensor? A pop-up selfie camera? This is no ordinary phone. I've been using it for a few days now, or trying to, anyway, and it's an excellent example of a Chinese company embracing new technologies and taking risks. That said, if you were thinking about importing one from China for the sheer novelty of it all, you should really hold off. The first thing everyone notices about the NEX S is its screen. It stretches almost completely across the phone's face without a notch in sight. Vivo went with a 6.59-inch AMOLED display, and you'd be hard-pressed to find another smartphone out there with a better screen-to-body ratio. The only one I can think of is Oppo's similarly ambitious Find X, and it's worth noting that Chinese conglomerate BBK Electronics controls both the Oppo and Vivo brands, so the competition here is mostly internal. In any case, it's a bright, punchy screen, though it only runs at 1080p, that means it's quite a bit less pixel-dense than other smartphones on the market. Crafting a phone with basically no bezels meant Vivo had to rethink how to lay out some important components, and ditch others altogether. Just look at the phone's earpiece. Oh wait, sorry, there isn't one. Instead, Vivo built a vibrating exciter beneath the screen that basically turns the entire panel into a speaker. I've only taken a handful of calls on the NEX S so far, but I was surprised at how well that actually works.